Today we are going to try the easiest way to replace the sky in Snapseed app. As we will be replacing the sky here, the first step is to make it as bright as possible. To do that selectively, the easy way is using the selective filters. We are going to start by adding one on this blue part of the sky. Make it as bright as it takes, also reducing the saturation. One here on the orangish part, again increasing the brightness. One here in these gaps of the trees. Couple more around the horizon. You can notice the brightness has leaked into the foreground. We will deal with that later. Also one here on the darker clouds. One on these hills will make it dark a bit. Now, going to the masking screen, we'll make sure to remove any brightness which was leaked into the foreground. You can repeat the same steps to make the sky more whiter. Or you can just select copy and then insert, which will repeat the last filters used. So we have almost a completely white sky here. Now with tune image, I'm going to decrease the shadows. This step is to make only the parts around the horizon darker. So in the masking screen, removing this effect on the bottom parts. Now using double exposure, I'm going to add a new stock sky image which I had downloaded separately. Moving it a little up so that the sun is just at the edge of the hills. Changing the mode to darken, which makes it visible only on the brighter parts of the image below. So going to masking screen and brushing out the sky image in the foreground. Just a little more precise around the horizon. Now, to match the foreground with the light and colors of the background, starting with curves, just darkening the image a bit by dragging the curve towards right. Going to masking screen and applying it on the darker part of the sky a bit. Also at the bottom where the light won't be hitting much. Again with curves, now lifting the blacks to make the overall image brighter. Also adding more red and green for that orangish tone. Going to masking screen, applying it around the sun to make that part more brighter. Next, applying vintage filter for a dark effect. Applying it on the lower part of the image. Some selective filters now. To make this crop more shiny, adding some brightness and contrast. Also one around here. We'll make this part in the background a little more dark. One here to make it pop a bit. To further pop the foreground, adding some hard contrast with curves. And applying it only on this part. Now for some subtle touch-ups with the brush tool. Some dodging around these areas to make it a little more brighter. Adding more saturation. Also more temperature around here to match it with the surroundings. Few more selective filters to give final touch-ups to the image. Reducing the saturation on these blue parts of the sky. Darkening this bright part of the sky. Little touch up on the leaves. Making this area a little more dark. And the final result. Thanks for watching.